Let's say you create online courses and sell them as part of your business. You might be facing two different kinds of people. Your genuine paying students, the audience, and the content pirates. In this video, we will see a few steps on tightening the security of your online video course content that you may have hosted using online teaching platforms, course platforms such as Thinkific, Teachable, or Kajabi. Or it could be even directly hosted on your Wistia account, which you would have, you would embed into your WordPress websites. Let's get started.
We have three parts to this video series and you're watching the first part right now. In this, we will see some steps to secure videos hosted directly on Wistia and how to protect videos within your WordPress dashboard using plugins. And in the second part, we'll explore some options we have to secure videos hosted on Teachable, Thinkific and Kajabi course platforms. And the last part, we'll go over some best practices to follow right at the time of creating video content itself. We'll also talk about some limitations about this approach and when to stop worrying about this entire problem. On the other hand, in this part, we'll also see some references and links to tools to complex procedures like creating .bif files to protect your videos from being downloaded. Alright, so here's how to tighten the security around your videos hosted directly on Wistia. Wistia has its account, projects, and then the course videos within the projects. First, at the account level, let's verify the embeddable options across domains. To check that setting, go to Account, Settings, and go to the account under the Profile Overview section. Then scroll down to check the domain restriction settings. If you enable this, you can control on which domains the videos can be embedded. By default, Wistia.com is always included. But you can go ahead and provide a comma separated domains list where your videos have to be embedded or where you want to allow to be embedded. So in this case, I'll just type in my domain names and save the settings. Next, after you're inside your Wistia dashboard, click on your project. By default, your project will be unlocked, which means anyone with that link to that project can access your videos within that project. You can also see that it's not logged by seeing this icon here. Click on this padlock icon to bring up the privacy and sharing pop-up and toggle this button to lock it. You can also get to this by clicking on this set privacy and sharing link. This is a project level setting. Since all your course videos may stay inside your project, it's important to provide this project level security before protecting your individual videos. Next, get into your individual videos where we can add a couple more security settings to them. I'm afraid we can only do these settings on a per video basis because setting the project defaults applies only to player color, buttons, etc. and not to other settings as per this note. First, sharing option settings. Go to Customize, Share, uncheck all the sharing options to remove the embed option for end users altogether. You can see that there's no embed option right here. But once you start checking any of these, you will see that there is an embed option available for any other options here. So make sure you uncheck all these options to completely remove the embedding button from the video player. Keep in mind, you can still embed on your own website by clicking on this embed and share button. Secondly, password settings. Within the same customize options menu, choose password and provide a password to view the video. Although it may annoy your users' experience with this setting, it definitely helps limit the spread of your video, disallowing users to watch your content until a password is entered, which you can share in an email with your student as soon as your course is purchased. A nominal feature, but it helps a step further in protecting content if you're keen about it.
The assumption here is that since we are using Wistia directly to host our video content, we will be using another destination such as our WordPress website to embed our Wistia videos. So let's also see how to secure our landing pages in our WordPress website where Wistia videos are embedded. Basically, one can get to the embed URL's hashed ID by visiting a website's source code by either inspecting element or going through the developer tools.
Here are a few WordPress plugins that can help us block such browser level access to the iframe or embed URLs, disable right click options, disable inspecting element options, etc. If you want to learn how to protect with similar settings but inside a blogger blog, then check my article here, which talks about how to disable text selection, disable right-clicking on the page, disable viewing page source, and disabling DevTools. You can also get an all-in-one code block from this page here. As a bonus, here's a tool you might want to consider. It's called Video Cipher, which offers more solid protection. For beginners, it's a bit pricey though, in my opinion, and I have not used this personally, but their offerings and overall reviews sounds promising. Do give that a try to protect your course videos.
Before I end this first part, I just wanted to highlight two things. One, previously in my channel, I have showed some methods on how people could download embedded videos. Check them out so you are aware on how anyone could get to your video content. Just remember that someone without the login credentials to your paid course cannot access your paid content unless you have made the content freely available on the internet. Although I have clearly mentioned in my videos to respect copyright policies and not to misuse it for illegal gains, I still had to create this video series to combat this problem. Not fully, but at least to the extent possible. Number two, I have come across some crazy loopholes in websites and blogs, sitemap to be specific, through which lead magnets and digital downloads could be easily downloaded, all without the knowledge of the website owners, without paying, without signing up to mailing list or anything. And I had reached out to many bloggers in the last few years, helped them and showed the loopholes in their websites, I still do, and how they should protect themselves from content pirates. I have even written a book about it some 4 years ago, which is still valid to this day. For what it's worth, I also wrote a post on Quora on how to spot spam websites. Why am I saying this now? Just to tell you that I take this seriously. And that's why I had to share this information on safeguarding the hard work by creators like you. This completes the first part of this video series in securing your video content and taking the protection one step further. In the second part, we will discuss some possible methods to make the illegal accessing tough enough on popular online course platforms like Teachable, Thinkific, and Kajabi. Just click on this thumbnail to watch it now.